Networks have never been as complex as they are today, and our apps are really key for unlocking new capabilities that operators will need to manage them effectively.
Agree. When I meet customers, I see that they struggle a lot with managing the increasing network complexity, while at the same time trying to sort of keep up the end user service experience. I also hear that they want to become more agile and innovative to unlock new revenue potential. And of course, they realize they cannot just do that by recruiting more people or, you know, deploy yet another stovepipe application. So the key word is transformation. They need to transform their operational processes, but also by using new smart technologies like AI machine learning. So, you know, what is happening right now on the market to enable this transformation?
Well, I would say one important thing is the introduction of SMO and non-real-time RIC. This has really put a lot of focus on openness and how important that is for a sustainable automation ecosystem. And Ericsson's approach is really to go beyond SMO, to cover purpose-built RAN as well. And the overall objective is to be able to consolidate many different automation applications on top of a single platform, and by doing that, avoiding these automation silos that you mentioned, Thomas. And we've been developing this platform for a few years now, and deployments are ongoing, so this is really happening now. But I mentioned rApps there. Can you explain what they are?
rApps are basically software applications sitting on top of this non-real-time RIC, as specified by OpenRAN. They consist of a number of microservices, data workflows, KPIs, data models, machine learning models, and all of these artifacts work together to automate specific type of use cases. So basically they are automation applications. An example could be going and finding an anomaly in the radio access network, understanding why that anomaly is happening, you know, the root cause analysis of it, and then having, you know, the problem fixed automatically. So that's an end-to-end type of use case. And the key thing is the split of the underlying platform's base and shared services from the rApps different business logic. That split enables us better efficiency, and it also enables accelerated development of new innovative automation rApps, you can say. But we're also investing in a broad ecosystem around it. So can you tell us a little bit more about that?
So this R1 interface that sits between the non-real-time RIC and the rApps allows for anyone to build them. So as you mentioned, Ericsson is building a lot of rApps, but so can operators themselves or third-party vendors. And we're really focusing now on building up and expanding an ecosystem in this space. It already today consists of a mix of third-party vendors and operators, and it's just been growing continuously. And what we bring is an SDK and a developer portal to make it as easy as possible to develop these rApps. And the aim is really to accelerate innovation in this space. But we mentioned a lot of potential now, but why should operators invest in rApps now?
I believe that instead of continuing investing in, you know, stovepipe automation solutions, both our customers and partners should now join this more horizontal concept from OpenRAN. That is more future-proof, and it also enables automation capabilities across the entire radio network. So as I mentioned, Ericsson, we are investing heavily in developing rApps, with many of the rApps out on the market today and many more in development. And the majority of these rApps contains advanced AI/ML capabilities that helps us solve a lot of different business needs for our customers. For example, how to accelerate network deployment, how to automate the entire network optimization process to boost performance, and also how to ensure that you operate your network in the most sustainable way.
So what we're really saying then is that this is an area we believe has tremendous potential, both to accelerate automation, but also unlocking innovation, and that it's possible to start this journey now.
For sure. So let's go.